President Buhari was in the U.S. from the beginning of the week attending the United Nations General Assembly. On Monday, President Buhari announced plans and initiatives by his government to reverse the negative effects of climate change. The plans were revealed in his address to the Climate Action Summit. Plans of the Nigerian government include the issuance of a green bond for irrigation and water supply.
We will take concrete steps to harness climate innovative ideas by including youth in decision-making processes as part of our overall climate governance architecture. We will mobilize Nigerian youth towards planting 25 million trees to enhance Nigeria's carbon sink.
On Tuesday, President Buhari explained that reducing extreme poverty and hunger is one of the cardinal objectives of his administration. He spoke in New York at the Nigeria high-level side event on SDG integration. To this end, the president launched an ISDG model, which will serve as a framework for robust, fact-based policy analysis, planning, and implementation at all levels of government.
It is expected to be used as a planning tool to complement existing ones currently in use at the national, sectorial, and sub-national levels.
President Buhari also delivered on Tuesday what would be his fifth address at the general debate of the United Nations General Assembly. Some issues have remained constant talking points since his first address, like the rights of the Palestinian people to have their own country and the risks associated with nuclear proliferation. But the Nigerian president explored a different tack, calling for the UN to lead the way in the replication of a Marshall Plan to consolidate development in Africa. He also made specific guarantees that a developed Africa would not be antagonistic to industrialized countries, but would become friends and partners in prosperity, security, and development.
A coordinated multilateral effort should be set in motion to utilize and maximize the use of the enormous resources on the African continent for the benefit of all nations. Current attempts to help develop Africa by industrial countries are uncoordinated and plainly incremental.
There is a more assertive president evolving, as is evident in his holding social media outlets responsible for fueling major crimes.
Major technical companies must be alive to their responsibilities. They cannot be allowed to continue to facilitate the spread of religious, racist, xenophobic, and false messages capable of inciting whole communities against each other, leading to loss of many lives.
Back at home, the Federal Executive Council, for the third week running, awarded contracts aimed at delivering capital projects running into billions of naira. The cabinet, which was presided over by Vice President Yemi Osinbajo, awarded contracts worth 311.47 billion naira. Three key contracts were approved for the Ministry of Works and Housing. The council approved the construction of the Ibadan Ile-Ife dual carriageway connecting Oyo and Osun states at the cost of 79.829 billion naira. Also approved was the 200.176 billion naira link road connecting the second Niger Bridge to Asaba and Onitsha. The 78-kilometer second phase of the Kano-Katsina Highway will cost 29.654 billion naira.
The award was to then expand the road into a dual carriage highway. So that meant reconstructing the existing one and building another one. So it was awarded, I think, for the first 70-something kilometers in phase one. What we're now doing is to complete the award to the same contractor.
The president will be back in Nigeria over the weekend in time for the independence anniversary celebrations. But he will be jetting out of the country again to meet President Cyril Ramaphosa of South Africa.